Hey, Ali here from Sports Templates, and today I'm bringing you guys a simple mock-up. This one is pretty much just basketball. So today we're going to be making the Golden State Warriors ball. I did some research on Google and I found this one. It doesn't look too clean, so I'm going to try to make a better attempt at making this ball. I already made my library with the main colors and the logo. The first thing I want to do is go to the add your logo here. This is a smart object, so we double click on the thumbnail here. And the smart object is split between the top part and the bottom part. So starting with the bottom part, I'm gonna change the background color to the blue. So I'm gonna bring the logo to the bottom part here. Everything is pretty much laid out for you, so you just wanna make sure that everything is centered and clean. So here, Alt-Shift, so I can resize my logo. And I think this is pretty okay. We need to hide the placeholder logo and just bring this one a little bit down. Now we're gonna make, now moving on to the top part. Same thing, hide this one. Bring in the Warriors logo. And make it really big. And looking at the image, I think it's a little bit tilted, so probably going something like this. Before we save, we gotta make this color blue as well. And Control S. Now you're gonna get this error message. I'm gonna get back to this later, but for now, just click OK. It looks pretty good. Now, the reason I got that error message is because I already added something that's called a displacement map. So if you zoom in a little bit and you look at how the logo is added to the ball, it's catching all the shadows and the highlights, but still, like, it's not this, the logo is not being displaced by the texture on the ball. So some people like it to be more realistic. So if you want to add a touch more realism, you gotta click this small arrow here and double click on displace. It's gonna show this box. Just click OK and load the displace file. This should be in your downloaded folder, so double click and just wait for it to do the displace thing. And now you get this effect. It's kind of visible here a little bit. So if this effect is too strong for you, or if you think it's distorting the logo too much, you can double click in here and just lower it however you want. So if you want like a slight distortion, maybe go with one and okay. Pick the file again. And now it's a little bit more easier to read, but still distorted. Now getting back to changing the rest of the segments of the ball, I have the full ball here, so you can change its color at once. So if you select the ball here and just click in here, it does change the color. And I like to make the straps yellow, so make it like this. But let's say you want to make this segment yellow for some reason. So here you have all the segments. So if you turn on the segments, each one is colored differently, so you can pretty much pick whichever segment and color it however you want. So that's if you want this to do like yellow. But for now, I'm gonna just hide it and go back to the main ball. And so that's pretty much it for the ball. The background is also editable. So if you go to the background, here you have the overlay layer and you have the main color layer. So if you go to the main color and pick the same blue, it's gonna show up like this. And then the text in the background is also editable. So let's say you want to have like Golden State, add Warriors here, right? And that's pretty much it. I went ahead and also did the front facing version of this, and also did the Cleveland Cavaliers. Also made like a couple fake teams, something like this, or just like a random Kings logo. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below, and stay tuned for more templates to come. Keep an eye on sportstemplates.net or .com. We have them both now, so just in case. See you guys later.
This is a Ryan Mitten production.